student, welcome to AD Lab. Today we will design a 8th experiment, that is design and implement mod n, n is equal to less than 8, synchronous up counter using JK flip-flop IC and demonstrate its working. Now here the value of n is given, n is less than 8, that means you can design counter for any value less than 8. In our case, we will design mod 5 counter, that is n value is equal to 5. So here in the design of mod 5, the counter has got 5 states, that is 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 1, 0, 0, 1, 1, 1, 0, 0. After that back to 0, 0, 0, that is it has got 5 state here, you can see. So to design mod 5 counter, first we need to know the excitation table of JK. So this is the E table of the JK. From the E table, you have to derive the state table. For the state table, we are going to derive, first giving first present state and next state. Then after that, we will try to find out the inputs of the flip-flop. That is, we will design input from the output. So we require present state. For example, 0, 0, 0 present state. What is the next state? 0, 0, 1. 0, 0, 1. What is the next state? 0, 1, 0. 0, 1, 0. What is the next state? 0, 1, 1. 0, 1, 1. Next state 1, 0, 0. 1, 0, 0. Next state is 0, 0, 0. For rest of the case, it is a don't care condition. Now, after that, you have to see, check the present state and next state with the E table, and you have to write the corresponding with the value of J and K. This you have to solve this one for K by using K map, and you have to find out the value of JC, KC, JB, KB, JA, KA. For this design part, please refer our counter topic in theory. Now, the related circuit diagram for mod 5 counter is this one. Here we need 27476 IC, and we need 1 AND gate IC, that is 7408. 1 AND gate 7408. So we need 27476. This is 17476, and this is one more 7476. 7476 is a 16 pin IC, and our AND gate 7408 is a 14 pin IC. And you have to make a note of the point here is, for 7476, VCC is the pin number 5 and ground is 13 for 7476. For 74708, VCC is 14 and ground is 7. So now we'll see how to connect this IC and what are the different connection. Let me explain here itself. Like you can see here, after making the VCC and ground connection, pin number 2 and 7 of the first IC along with pin number 2 of the second IC goes to something called as a preset input, preset, which is used to set the input, preset. Now pin number 3, 8 and pin number 3 of the second IC goes to clear input. Other than that, pin number 1, pin number 6, pin number 1, we have to short together, and we have to connect it to clock signal. Either you can use monoclock or autoclock. So now we will see how to connect this one. As you can see here, we are using 27476 IC. It is a 16 pin IC. 7476 is a 16 pin IC. Let me connect this IC now. So I will connect this 7476 IC here to the IC holder. So I have connected one more 7476. Other than that, I have connected 7408 AND gate. So I have 27476 and AND gate. So first connection is VCC and ground. You have to remember here, 5 is VCC in the case of 7476. 5 is VCC. So both for the both IC, I will connect 5 and 5 to VCC. Next, 13 is ground. So 13 of this IC is connected to ground. Similarly, 13 of this IC is connected to ground. Now we will move to 7408. 7408, 14 is VCC. So instead of 14 pin IC, you know 14 is VCC. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14. And 7 is ground, 7 is connected to ground. Once this is done, we will connect a preset signal. You can see here, preset signal 2 of first, pin number 2 of first IC and pin number 7 of first IC, you will short it together, then connect it to pin number 2 of second IC. So let me take pin number 2 of first IC, pin number 2 of first IC and pin number 7 of first IC. So pin number 7 of first IC, some students they will get confused here, pin number 7 of first IC, and we have to connect this to pin number 2 of second IC. From that point we have to take one more signal. From this point we have to take one more signal and that goes to preset, and this is called as preset here, preset input. Similarly here you can see pin number 3 and 8 of first IC shorted together with the 3 of the second IC. So pin number 3 and pin number 8 shorted, and from here take one more connection tapping. Tapping that goes to pin number 3. From pin number 3 you take one more tapping, that goes to input, that is called clear. So here you can see the blue patch cord is a preset and the red patch cord is black patch cord is clear. Now we will do the connection of clock signal. You can see here clock signal, that is 1, 6 and 1. 1 and 6 of first IC is connected with 1 of the second IC. So 1 goes to 6. So this is the pin number 6 here. You can see pin number 6. From 6 it goes to pin number 1 of the other IC, second IC. From second IC I will take tapping and I will connect that to either to auto clock, this is auto clock 1 hertz, or you can use a mono clock also. So in case of mono clock you have to use this switch. In case of auto clock it will work automatically. After completing these connections, we will move to this one. QA is connected to pin number 15 is connected to pin number 9. From there you have to take on tapping and it goes to pin number 1 of the AND gate. Similarly, from the same point you have to take on tapping and you have to connect it to pin number 12. From 12 it goes to LSB, that is QA. LSB output QA. Similarly, pin number 11 is QB, and pin number 15 is QC. So in the design, QC is actually MSB and QA is LSB. So here you can see we have completed the connection. Here you can see this is actually QA, QB and QC. This is MSB and this is LSB. This is QA, QB and QC. So students, you can see here the connections are done already, and let me repeat once again, 74762 IC and 74081 IC, and this is the output QC, QB, QA, and this is preset and clear, and we have connected clock as the input here. You see counter counts clock cycle. So clock as input here, I have given the clock to the I have connected clock to the auto clock. You can use the manual clock also here. You can use the manual clock also. Okay, in our case we have connected it to auto clock. Now we will see first. We will switch on the trainer kit. Here you can see, you see preset and clear. So always you have to, preset is used to set. Preset is used to set the value and clear is used to clear. So both should be always high. Preset and clear both should be always high. So
students, now we'll see how the preset works. For explanation purpose, I have connected a clock to monopulse here. Now you see here, this is a preset signal. So if I change the state, preset will set the output. You can see here, I am changing the state here. Preset will remain same as a 1 in the output. You can see here. Similarly, next one is the clear. If I change the state, clear will clear the output. You can see here. Preset, if I change the state, it will remain 1, and clear, if I change the state, it will remain 0. Finally, you have to keep both preset and clear input as I. So now we'll connect this to mono clock, and here you can see the output 0, 1, 1, 0, 1, 1, 1, 0, 0, 0. So this is nothing but implementation of a mod 5 counter. It will count from 0 to 0 to 4, 5 states. So only thing is, you have to remember here about the settings of preset and clear. Please keep preset and clear as always high, and you can connect the clock to either auto clock, or if it is not, you can connect it to mono clock. Thank you.